Welcome back, guys. It's Acid Glow here. So I want to talk about a couple of things in Killer Instinct. So the first thing is arcade mode. So it's speculated that it's supposed to be released at the end of March, alongside the same time as when Fulgor and possibly the other alternate or classic costumes are supposed to arrive. And I think the last two are either maybe Thunder and Spinal, or maybe Thunder and Sadira. I guess we'll see. So arcade mode. So on the weekend, when I had that problem with the patch where I couldn't even get to the title screen and the game just kept crashing and then it kept shutting down on me, I was like, okay, you know what? I'm gonna fire up Killer Instinct Classic, play some arcade mode and get some damn achievements. So I was playing that game and I realized, you know what? It feels kind of weird. Like, I tried the D-pad, it didn't feel that good for me, so then I tried the left thumbstick, it was a little bit better, but for some reason, like with Jago, I could not get his ultra combo, and the inputs are just the wind kick with weak kick, and for some reason, I would always get like a weak wind kick at the end of my last auto double set. It was really weird because I don't know what was going on. I don't know if maybe the inputs changed or the timing was changed when they actually tried to emulate the arcade version and then onto a console. I don't know, maybe something went wrong there. It's kind of weird. So I was playing arcade mode with Fulgor, Thunder, Jago, TJ Combo. I think just those ones, yeah. And I realized how much I really like playing with TJ Combo. He's a really fun character, and I really do hope he comes back for Season 2. Assuming we get all the originals, I guess we'll see, you know? So I was thinking, arcade mode, man, Idol is such a fucking bitch in that game. That character is so damn cheap. And so it got me thinking, when arcade mode gets released for this game, how many people are actually going to play it a lot? Because it's pretty much the same as survival mode, except there's a boss and then an ending and that's it. So, you know. What I think is going to happen is people are going to play arcade mode once with each character just to get the ending and then be done with it. Because that's pretty much what it is. It's just like survival mode, except with an ending after so many characters. And I really hope they introduce a new boss character. Even if it's Shadow Jago with a new moveset, I just want a new boss character. At least something, man. I don't want to fight like, you know, Jago the third time and then say, here's your ending. But it would be really badass if they brought back Idol. I want him more than Gargos or a different boss character. He was such a bitch, but he was just so damn cool. I liked him. So the other thing I want to talk about is the connection status between two players online. Now, I was wondering, like, why this game does not have a visible connection status. Like, you know, some games like Street Fighter 4, Marvel, and Mortal Kombat 9, and Injustice. I'm pretty sure Injustice has this. But some fighting games out there, they have a set number of bars showing you the strength of the connection between two players. So it got me thinking, why doesn't Killer Instinct have this? Like, in ranked matches, it might not be necessary because when you're paired up with someone in ranked matches, you gotta play it or you just kind of shut down your console or shut down the program if you want to quit or back out. But in exhibition, I think it'd be a good idea to have it because in exhibition, that is where you actually have the opportunity to back away other than just go in there and if it's too laggy, you gotta freaking close the program. So I was wondering, you know, why is there no connection bar status in exhibition at least or in this game at all? And so this brings me to the last topic of the video, and that is the lobby system that was spoken about during a live stream on, I think, December. And they said that it was supposed to come out in January, but January came and went, and we never saw it at all. So I'm hoping we do get the lobby system at the end of March, along with the release of Fulgor, arcade mode, and extra classic costumes. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Now, lobby mode, I think, is going to be the best thing for the multiplayer in this game because lobby mode also has spectator mode in other fighting games. So if they have both of those features in that system there, then it's going to work great. Assuming the netcode holds up because the lobby system is supposed to be like two characters are fighting and there could be like maybe 3 to 6 characters that are actually watching the match and spectating it live as it happens. And so when the match finishes, the loser is pushed down to the bottom of the list and the next person on the ladder is actually going to step up to play. So for myself, I think arcade mode is not going to have a huge impact. I think the lobby system is going to be what's going to keep the multiplayer going on and on. But what about you guys? Is there a specific game feature or a piece of DLC content you want to see in the game by the end of March or possibly later down the road on Season 2? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section, leave a thumbs up, and I will see you guys later on. I'm out.